You are now watching Make Them Respect You Part 2. Walk a mile in my shoes.
Money ain't a thing if I got it. Money ain't a thing if I got it. Money.
Before the money, there was love. But before the money, it was tough. Became the money through a plug. It's a shame this ain't enough, yo. Sitting back plotting, jotting information on my nation. Really started from the bottom, boycotting. But they still planting plantations, we keep buying it. Closed-minded man, products higher than the prices on your products. And Balenciagas, balance my saga with the Henny Agua. Me and my trying to eat you empanada. The flow like plenty lava, with just a penny I can multiply my wolf and make it work for me for 20 hours. I swear these love the copy, thanks for listening. Nigga, they been the saints since Biggie smacked me at my christening. Watch what you dishing. Please play your safe, cause your position on the top is switching right in front of your face. Rocket wide in space with rhymes, I'm busting now. Keep ducking down, got some missiles now. Headed for your house, so put the pistols down. Got that red dot.
Hello?
Yeah, it's there, mate. Y'all still warming up or something, right? Y'all still warming up or something, right? Real quick. I'm being there a little bit. Yeah, so we here. I mean, it's time to put that hard work into action.
Come on, to the right. Yeah. One more.
I think I met Devon
like 2011, 2012. It was like coming out of his, coming into his seventh grade year. His little brother played AAU with me, San Leandro Lions, what have you. We just started the organization. And his little brother was like, yo, my brother can play. You know, he's a grade up. I was like, okay, you know, we're gonna practice, you know. I already knew it was in the system, what have you. So, little dude comes to the car the next day, got a little do-rag on, pants sagging. I'm like, are you about to go play basketball, bro? You know you about to go play basketball, right, bro? Like, yeah, I'm good. All right. Like, yo, you come in this car again, man. I want you to look like a basketball player. Don't come in here looking like you about to go play at Brookdale or Sunnyside or something like that. I'm like, all right, I got you, coach. Right then and there, I was like, yo, bro, it could be something. Because he respected that. You know what I'm saying? He really respected that. But, you know, years go by. He changed. You know what I mean? They practiced. Them dudes got real, real good together. You know, him, his little brother. You know, they helped each other out. That's something that's huge, you know, that's missing in Oakland, man. Me living out here, growing up out here, the Bay Area, working with the youth right now, I see that big time. I see that's a huge thing that's needed, your peers to push you. So, you know, the story goes on, man. Tournaments, dude scoring at will. Dude gets to high school and he's real curious because, you know, everybody's like, you gotta be this big, you gotta be this tall. That's why his favorite player is, you know, of course, the mighty Stephen Curry. But little guys, he's starting to see the little, it's a little guy's game. And as long as you work hard at it, you don't have to, like, you know, you'll be successful somewhere. You know, you just got to work hard at life because, you know, on and off the court, bro was brilliant. We're talking about seventh grade, bro, 0.7 student. Now, you know, he gets to high school, he's 3.0s, and he got it together. Like, I mean, he did that in middle school. He went from a 0.7 to a 3.8 in one freaking semester after he, like, told me he was going to do it. You know, so, like, I knew he was capable of doing stuff like that. But very proud of the young man, and you guys will see. Cause basketball is not just about what happens on the court. And I think that's what he understands now. You gotta believe, man. And if you don't wanna believe him, better respect him.
I always work out at Alliance Middle School in East Oakland. Luckily, the janitor, Angie, lets me up there, and I work out from about 9 to 11 every day. When I'm working out, I don't mind mistakes after mistake, after mistake, man. After mistake. I miss shots, I lose the ball a lot, all of the above, but I know when it's game time, everything else would be tight because in practice, I already messed up, already lost the ball, already missed a shot. So in the game, everything would be cleaned up because I was pushing myself.
and respect you.
MTRY. That's work right there.
I've been in the foster care system since I was about 9 years old. I grew up in the system with my big sister, Tominique. We've been through a lot, like being in foster care, being separated from your brothers, sisters, mom, dad. After a while, it could take a toll on you. But somehow, me and my sister still managed to overcome all these obstacles and still be successful in school, in sports. For me, she still plays sports, but not as much as I do. I just follow in her footsteps because she gets really good grades. She's all about success, and here and there, I always fall off. Well, I fall sometimes, like when stuff pops up with my family, or I just get sidetracked. So I follow her because she stays. She's always focused. A lot of people don't know because I don't really say my business that much, but my mom has been in the hospital for a long time, probably like over 5 years, and a couple days ago she passed away. Ever since then, I haven't really been in the gym as much. I probably skipped like 5 days in the gym, because I mean, your mom passed, I mean, that's like big, like for anybody to take on. I'm back in the gym now. I go to Arizona tomorrow for Arizona State's basketball tournament. Hopefully that rust don't kick in, because I'm gonna need to perform really good, really well. Because no one cares about if your mom passed or whatever's going on. They just care about if you can get the job done or not. So I'm gonna try to, hopefully I can do that tomorrow. My mom is like my best friend, you know? Like, my whole life I've been in foster care, separated from my dad, even though he was never really there like that, my sister, my family, but like, I always feel like I didn't really have nothing like that, but now that my mom's gone, it's like, that was kind of like all I had, besides like my sister and stuff. There's still people there for me and stuff, but like, ain't nobody like your mom. Like people say, first love is your mom. That's the first person you see when you come out. Like, now that's just like, it just took it away from me forever. But what keeps me from crying still and stuff like that is I know that she's in paradise now. At first, when she was in the hospital, she was paralyzed from the neck down. She couldn't move. My mom always the type, she got ADD. She won't admit it, but she got ADD. She always moving. She always wanted to go somewhere. But in that hospital, she was paralyzed from the neck down. She couldn't move. The only thing she could do was talk. So I know now, at least I know that she's resting in paradise. She's resting in paradise right now. And so I feel like stopping, because I mean, this is like big for me, really, really big, as you can see. But I'm gonna do it for her. I'm gonna keep continuing to work hard, do good in school. I'm gonna do everything. I'm just dedicated to my mom and do it for her. I know that she wouldn't want me to start messing up now. I came too far for this. So she always told me she wanted to cruise around the world. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get a tattoo right here. It's gonna be a boat and water and stuff like that. And it's gonna represent her saying that she wants to cruise around the world on a boat. I'm not gonna go on a cruise around the world because I don't do boats. I could swim, but you know, I'm not messing with that. But yeah, so I'm gonna just continue her legacy, our legacy for my sister and everybody else, because it's not just about me. It's bigger than me, it's about my family. The people that look up to me, all of it. So I love my mom, but I know that she would love to see me make it far, whether she's here or not, because I know, and she knows that she always will be in my heart. Like I said, I really love my mom a lot, and she's like, don't get me wrong, I'm happy that she's in paradise and all, but then again, I do this every day for her. I get up, I grind, I go to school, I do all for her, and it's like, now she's just gone forever, and it's like, I want to go to college, I want to play college ball, I want to do all those things for her so she can see me like we came from nothing. Like when I say we came from nothing, we have a pot to piss in at all. But I wanted to do all this and show her like, for me, we made it now. But I mean, she's gone forever now. But I mean, I know she's still watching over me and stuff, but this was just all for her and she's just not here no more. So I mean, like, my mom even tried to make my graduation. I mean, she was paralyzed from the neck down. She still tried to make my graduation. That's how determined my mom is and how hard of a worker she is. I get the hard work from her. So, I mean, she was paralyzed, still trying to come. They couldn't get her, though, because the wheelchair and it just wasn't enough time to do it. But I felt bad because she felt bad. And she felt bad because she was like, oh, my son probably don't love me. No, not that. She was like, my son is disappointed or whatever, like, cause I couldn't make it. But what she don't know is I was actually proud, cause she's really trying to work and try to get to my graduation, even though she was paralyzed. Like, that means a lot. I remember going up to the hospital and seeing her. Every time I go in, I say, "Hey, mom." She want to call the whole hospital in the room. "Hey, this is my son, NBA star. Hey, yeah, you. This is my son. Yeah, he going to the NBA. He rap. He do everything. This is my son. He gonna pay for my cruise around the world." I'd be like, "Mom, okay, they get the point. Like, all right, I got you." But yeah, like, even that. So when I graduated, I went up to the hospital before she passed. I went to the hospital and I gave her my graduation cap, and it said MTRY on it. And everybody knows that means "Make Them Respect You." Well, for the people that don't know, MTRY stands for "Make Them Respect You." That's my little motto thing. So I'm just keep striving for her. That's the last thing I left her, MTRY. So I'm gonna carry on that legacy, "Make Them Respect You." So yeah, I remember being homeless and not having nowhere to live, like being on the streets, even living in motels, kind of like with me and my little brother. He was just a baby, like one. We had to sleep in motels. We didn't have no money to stay nowhere else. We got evicted, so we're just on the streets, barely eating. I mean, my mom always made a way. No matter when there wasn't a way, she always made a way. But I mean, like I said, we just always on the streets. We always like just had it really hard. But like they say, God give his hardest battles to his toughest soldiers. So "Make Them Respect You," MTRY. Mama, this for you.
I done gave the child too many years, years that I won't get back. And I swear I done said too many tears for that I won't get back. Yeah, I got in the graveyard, in the state yards. I swear not a day goes by that I don't think about the times. I wish that I could rewind.